Hi everyone, it's Bernadette, Simply Be Art, and this is the awaited bloom using South African paints. Glue and water is my pouring medium, and a teddy acrylic paint as my pillow paint. So I'm going to do a short video on my process so that you can follow along and get good results as well. So I'm using a wooden coaster, and I've put some masking tape on the back, just tore off a piece and folded it over. And I'm using a mini turntable. It's used for cupcakes, decorating little biscuits and cupcakes, and it works perfectly and it's nice and smooth. So I'm going to stick the coaster onto the mini turntable. And I'm going to pour the teddy acrylic paint straight onto the coaster, or directly onto the coaster. I'm going to tell you about my paints in a little while. So I'm going in a circular motion with the teddy paint straight out of the bottle. It's a nice thick consistency and it dries really well. So just covering the coaster three quarters of the way, just like that. Got it? Once again, that's what I've put as my base coat. Now my colors are burnt sienna, and I've mixed it 1:1 to my pouring medium, one part paint to one part pouring medium. And this is the brand that I'm using. I'm using Dala brand of paint. So this is the burnt sienna, and my pouring medium is just glue and water. My regular pouring medium, white craft glue and water. The next color is this metallic. It's a peacock. Dala's peacock, and once again I've mixed it one part paint to one part pouring medium. Sorry, this is Viridian, Dala's Viridian, and I'm going to use that as my colors, these three colors as my colors on my coaster. So I'm using a craft stick, and I'm going to just dip three times into the center. You'll notice that the consistency is rather a thick consistency. Here we go. Let's do another one. Okay, I'm happy with that. My next color is peacock. This is a metallic, as mentioned. That's enough. And this is the Viridian. Just one scoop of that Viridian. My cell activator, and the size of about a 20 cent piece. All right, I'm going to torch that. And now I'm going to blow. So I'm going to blow down right into the middle, almost right down to the base, to the pillow paint. And then I'm going to start blowing and spreading the paint out to the edges of this coaster. So I'm going to do that, and then I'm going to show you what it looks like. But let me show you what it looks like now. So I'm going to take the teddy paint again and I'm going to fill up those edges where there is still wood covered. The paint is going to spread a lot, but I want to cover those edges. Oops. All right. That's okay. I'm going to torch it again. So you've got to let your coaster rest for a while to allow those cells to develop. And it takes about, give or take about a minute, minute and a half. You don't want to rush the bloom technique. It's something that develops first and then you spin. So let me show it to you again. You can see how those cells are developing. While that's developing, I'm going to cover my tubs and store it away. So when you're doing your blooms, you can pace yourself nicely. There's no rush. I'm only doing one bloom just to show you. So when you're doing a series of them, then you can keep your tubs open. And you can see how much, this is a 70 ml tub, and I've just mixed up 30 grams of paint with 30 grams of the pouring medium, and it will last me quite a while depending on how many coasters I'm going to be making. So I'm just going to store it away and use it for the next time. And while I've done that, this is nicely sealed up. I'm going to spin it and then you can see how I do that. But let me bring you down to the closer to the table. I think you have a better view now. I've brought you down a little bit more closer to the to my view. I want the I've placed a bottle here just to lift up the linen saver so that it catches the splashing. There's not much splashing with the with this mini spinner, but I do like to just cover things. So let's spin this out. You don't want to also spin it too much and wreck what you have. I think that's all I'm going to do. I'm going to torch it in the center, and that's the only torch I will do. So let me bring this up to you so you can have a closer look. I'm going to show you one that I made earlier. It's been drying for about a half an hour now. So that's the partner. There we go. I've enjoyed doing that for you. I hope you enjoyed the video too. Very short video. Take care and stay well, everyone. Bye for now.